I'm talking to the MD of Manx Radio. We're talking, Chris, about your life on this interview. We got as far as Radio Caroline. How did you get the Manx Radio bug? I mean, you kind of did go for a job here already or something.
I did,
before,
yeah.
Right?
So I'd heard Manx Radio as a kid, as an anorak. You used the term in part one. Yeah. I am an anorak. I love radio. I love audio. I love just the passion for radio. I think you talked about Caroline as well. I remember sitting on Radio Caroline one day doing a show with this massive medium wave transmitter. And we had a big map in the studio. And if you got letters from odd places, you'd stick a little pin in the map. And at that stage, the iron curtain was still very much up, and we'd get letters from East Berlin and Russia and whatever else. People saying, please don't mention my name or anything, but just say Eric in Berlin and I'll know what it is.
It must be exciting to know you're making differences.
And that kind of thing, and exactly, just the thought that this radio signal was just blasting out into the ether and you had no idea where it was going. And that kind of stirred a passion. So as a kid, I'd listened to Luxembourg and to Caroline and to Manx Radio.
You with get on AM
on, in Kent at night time? Yeah, absolutely. 1368 would come
what
in.
What are you talking about here?
This would have been late 70s, early 80s.
Oh my God, it might be me then.
No, well, it could well have been you. It didn't put me off. I stayed with it anyway. I just loved, again, yeah. It was that magic of it and hearing this thing from somewhere remote.
There's something weird about AM, isn't it?
There is.
Coming and going.
Yeah, and Luxembourg fading in and out, obviously. So I'd heard Manx Radio back then. I then came back across Manx Radio at the same time I joined the RAF Reserves, came back to the UK and took up a job with BFBS looking after all of our UK bases. So lots of travel, Edinburgh, Northern Ireland, Catterick, Colchester, whatever. And I started doing Radio Caroline again. I got invited back and I was doing a Saturday show on Radio Caroline as a volunteer. You don't get paid for
back
it.
Now in port, right?
This is back in, well, in fact, Essex, I was doing this from my studio home. So it did, yeah. So, but they have a studio and an office in Kent. And the ship is still there, which we'll come back to.
Yeah.
And in September of that year, they said, we're going to start doing monthly broadcasts from the ship again. And Manx Radio are kindly loaning us their 1368 transmitter, and it's to do with the Radio Caroline North thing. Do you want to come out? I was like, yeah. I was going to say no to that.
Fantastic.
So, and it was weird going back on the ship for the first time in 30 years and stepping up. It felt like the years just dropped away. You were back, you were 19 again. The banter was the same. The thing that was hardest, though, was getting out of bed at the night. When you have the old man wee in the middle of the night, and you think, I need to use the loo. No, I don't. And the reason you put yourself off is because getting in and out of the bunk as a 19-year-old was a whole lot easier than it is at 50-odd. So that was...
Obviously, technology's moved a lot, though, hasn't it? I mean, you were there when it's all really, really...
records
and parts and things, and that's all...
Vinyl.
Even Caroline must be all digital, is it?
So we have two studios. We have the Heritage Studio, which is the original studio, and it was also the one that was used in the film The Boat That Rocked.
Yeah.
They wanted to film the film on the boat, but it was too small by the time they'd have put the lights and the cameras in. There was no room for the actors. So they borrowed every bit of equipment down to literally the kitchen sinks from our cabin, took those away, recreated it at Pinewood or Elstree and did that. Yes, so we have the Heritage Studio, and next door is a more modern studio, which is the computer database for the music, similar to...
Anyway, back to you. Manx Radio was calling you
somewhere. So Manx Radio, so I came across Manx Radio and got Chris Williams came out and did that first weekend with us. So I got chatting to him and Mark Tiley. Got chatting, heard a bit more about Manx Radio. Well, this is great. And then around about a year later, I'd carried on doing those shows and heard and listened to Manx online a little bit. This is good. And the job came up. Mark Tiley was leaving, and I applied for that job. Came over.
That's program controller.
Program controller. Didn't get the job. Alex got it. I've forgiven you. I've forgiven you, Alex. We're over it. We're good.
So you didn't get that one, but you got the better job higher job. Actually.
So then this opportunity came up last summer. I was in Germany, running BFBS in Germany at that stage, this came up, and I applied, and here I am, basically. So
we've done another interview about the Manx Radio thing, but just in general, do you think this is something you want to stay with, or is it something you just want to get right and then you'll go back to something else?
I'm really enjoying it. I think it's a great place to live. It's been as we talked about in the last interview, it was a full-on few months going through that process. It wasn't the easiest time. There were times when I doubted and thought, have I done the right thing? I've left a secure, comfortable job, as we all do, and you think, okay, but it worked and that's fine and I like it, and we got a great team and it's a great place to live. I love running, and you've got some great places to run around here and stuff.
And it should be stated that you do a little bit of work on the radio.
I do, yeah, work.
I mean, you use them names.
Is
that allowed to say that?
No, it's absolutely fine. Okay. So I use Pearson on it, and that's a throwback to Radio Caroline again.
Right.
So 19 years old, as I said, we were in a car going down to Ramsgate. They were taking me out to the ship, And they said, what name are you going to use? And I said, Chris Sully, why? Mm. I said, well, you can't, it's pirate, you have to change it. So I was like, ah, okay. So I looked around and I was sitting on a cardboard box, and it, on the side of the box it said Pearson's Apples. So I went, that's it, I'll be Chris Apple. They said, no, use the other bit. But yeah, Chris, Chris Pearson came from a box of apples, and I just kept it. So all of my radio work with the FBS and the commercial stations I worked for in Manchester and Chilton and Invicta and stuff were as Chris Pearson.
And the rest is history.
Hopefully I'm not, though. But yeah, to answer your question, love it here. This is great. This is a great place to live.